part of being an empowered space advocate is being an educated space advocate. And that means understanding how missions come together, what it takes to get something sent into space. As an example, today I'm going to show you how scientists and NASA come together to decide where on the surface of Mars to send the next Mars rover. Now, this mission is going to be really interesting. It's based on the Curiosity rover design. So it's the same body shape, it uses the same landing system, but the most interesting new feature this mission is going to have is the ability to prepare samples of the surface of Mars to be retrieved by a future mission and returned back to Earth. So before the scientists can even begin to think about where they want to land, they need to know where they can't land. And that's all driven by engineering considerations. Basically, where it's unsafe for the rover to attempt to land on the surface. So, part of the problem of landing on Mars is that you have to stay warm enough once you're on the surface. And so that automatically rules out the poles. In fact, any Mars rover is going to be stuck between positive 30 and negative 30 degrees latitude on the surface of Mars, basically around the equator. Then you rule out mountaintops, you rule out chasms, canyons, any place that's really windy or dangerous. Then you even have to think about places too high up. You need enough air to slow you down in your parachutes. It's only then that you start looking at the science potential for these remaining places.
The science community selects their landing sites. We're down selected to 8 now. From an engineering point of view, I think we're trying to do better for science, so we can choose landing sites that have a certain kind of obstacle because we're going to be using images from our orbiters that we have on board the vehicle as we're descending, and we can do divert maneuvers around a small type obstacle. So these small type obstacles that used to cause us to move our whole ellipse, we can now divert around them. That's a great capability from an engineering perspective to enable the scientists to go closer to the stuff they want.
At the first landing site workshop, they presented over 30 different sites. In this 2.5 day long workshop, scientists from around the world get up and pitch their favorite sites to the rest of the room and to a larger community watching online. And at the end of it, they'll do a pretty old-fashioned vote on a variety of different scientific measures of each site and try to select the top 8 most intriguing sites that meet the scientific criteria for this mission. From those 8, scientists over the next few years will debate and research and argue to find the one. Understanding where and how we decide to land on Mars is just part of being a space advocate. It's understanding and appreciating that this process isn't entirely behind closed doors, that it's open to people to follow and to critique and to suggest and to engage with. And this is why we need to always support these missions, even at early stages, so the stability is there, so we get the best science outcome at the end.